Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1385, UDF from Personal Macro Workbook. All right, well, hey, this is a VBA podcast, but we're going to go back to episode 1375 when I created a tiny little user-defined function called join. If you remember, I was frustrated with the concatenate function in Excel, and so I created this little UDF. I got an email from Lon. Lon said, hey, that was brilliant, but I tried to put it in the Personal Macro Workbook. Doesn't work anymore. He also said, hey, why doesn't it work with CHAR10, the line feed character? And let's just address that one real fast. CHAR10. So you see it jams everything together. What you have to do is you have to format cells and then go into alignment and turn on wrap text. Click OK. Of course, oh, hey, that's up there in the Excel 2007 or 2010 ribbon. I keep forgetting it's there. It's nice that it's there. Okay, but here's, you know, Lon's problem. He took that macro and he moved it to his Personal Macro Workbook. Let's go into VBA with Alt F11. We're going to take that macro code from episode 1375. We're going to cut that. And let's see over here in our Personal.xlsb. Find the modules. See that we have a few macros there already. I'll paste this one in. All right. Now, you know, for regular old subroutines that don't start with function, they just start with sub, those work perfectly in the Personal Macro Workbook. It's a great, great way to go. But unfortunately, now it does not work anymore. And what Microsoft wants you to do, and I think this is ridiculous, is you have to put the name of the workbook. So equal personal.xlsb exclamation point, and then all of a sudden it works. But who's going to type that every single time? So, here's my solution to this. I want you to create just a brand new workbook, Control N, and so right now it's called Book 2. We'll go back to VBA. We'll take this code from Personal, Control X, and here's our new workbook, insert a module, paste. All right, so now that is part of Book 2, and then we'll go back to Excel. See, I'm in Book 2, File, Save As. Files of type, and we're going to look through the list for an add-in. We're going to save this as an add-in right there. So it's an XLAM instead of XLSM, and we're just going to call it join macro add-in. Now, hey, notice here that they're automatically storing it in the add-ins folder, and that actually is going to work out very nicely for us here in a couple of seconds. All right, so that's it. Workbook with no data whatsoever, just the macro got saved. Life is good. I'm actually going to close Excel. Okay, so we reopen Excel. I need to get back to the old add-ins manager. You know, the easiest way to do that is Alt-T followed by the letter I. Brings up the old add-ins manager. And right there, it's already in the list, join macro, just choose that, click OK. All right, now what's the difference? It's not in a Personal Macro Workbook anymore, it's in a little add-in that I just created. The beautiful thing about that is when I need to use it, I can just type equal join, and for whatever reason, I don't know what their rationale behind this is, anything in an add-in, an open add-in, you don't need to prefix it with the add-in name, it just automatically works. All right, so it's like the concept of the Personal Macro Workbook, but it's used for your user-defined functions. And oh, hey, by the way, if you get more user-defined functions, we'll just put them right in that same add-in. So let's see, where's it? JoinMacro.xlam. There's the module. You can paste more functions in here, and they'll all be available. So it's like having your own Personal Macro Workbook, but it's a personal user-defined function workbook. Store it as an add-in, and then things will automatically work. All right, so there you have it. When you have a user-defined function, instead of going to Personal XLSB, create your own XLAM, or if you're back in Excel 2003, an XLA, and store it there. You will then have access to that all the time. I want to thank Lon for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.